Good morning, students. We have seen about the oxidation reaction of glucose and fructose. So now let us see the apimers. Apimers and anomers. Okay. Let us see now what do you mean by apimers and anomers. Before going to this, we should know about the diastereomers. And in the first semester, I think in the second semester, you will be having the enantiomers and diastereomers. So, coming to here, what do you mean by enantiomers? Non-superimposable mirror images, we call it as enantiomers, means which cannot be superimposable. That one we call it as non-enantiomers, and superimposable mirror images. Superimposable mirror images, we call it as diastereomers here. And superimposable mirror images, I'm saying. Let us take example of O, alphabet O. So, when you take alphabet O, when you pass a plane of light, what happens? Two equal parts you are getting. But here, like this, it will not get. This one, we call it as superimposable mirror images compared to diastereomers. Diastereomers is also known as asymmetric stereoisomerism. Symmetric means enantiomer which travel in same direction, which is in opposite different directions. Okay, so here we'll be having chiral carbons, here we are going to have achiral carbons. So now I'm taking one example, COOH, OH, H, CH2OH, and plane of mirror is placed, H, COOH, CH2OH. So means what here, if you observe that OH functional group is in right side, here it is in left side. So these two forms we call it as enantiomers generally. Then coming to diastereomers. Diastereomers is nothing but here H, COOH, OHH. I have taken tartaric acid example, COHH, OHH, COOH, COOH. When you have taken tartaric acid, see here OH is rotating, means here also it has to rotate. But what happening here? Here it is not rotating to the third carbon, only second carbon is rotating. Means what? Only one change in the configuration. So these two molecules we call it as diastereomers, means which are superimposable each other. That one we call it as diastereomers. If you take OH, this carbon, then it will rotate. You are considering only this carbon, second carbon. So that's why we are getting this one. Now coming to apimers. Apimers is nothing but differ only in C2 carbon. We call it only second carbon, it is going to differ. That when we call it as apimers, means the definition will be a pair of diastereomeric aldoses. Aldoses that differ only in configuration at in configuration about C2 are called APMers. Okay, so here a pair of diastereomeric aldoses means two types of diastereomeric compounds we are taking. Aldose is nothing but it consists of 5 carbon atoms. Okay, that one we call it as aldose. So they differ only in configuration at about C2, means at second carbon only it should show some stereometrism. So that's why we call it as this one APMers. Example, if we have taken, means here I'm taking glucose and mannose. OH, HOH, OHH, OH, CH2, OH. This one example of D+ glucose. And here CHO, COHH, OHH, D+ mannose. In the definition, what I have told you, a pair of diastereomeric aldoses. So coming to here, two pairs I'm taking when a plane of mirror is passed. So what happens, this OH, only this OH is changing. Means what, here this, here it is in right side, here it is in left side. Have you observed or not? But at this is the first carbon, second carbon, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you have observed, means what I have told you, at only second carbon it is showing diastereomerism. So means what, here at second carbon the OH is in right side, the OH is in left side. So this one we call it as APMerism. If suppose it is in right side, we call it as glucose. If suppose it is in left side, we call it as mannose. Okay, so this is the example of APMers. APMers means what? A pair of diastereomeric aldoses differ only in configuration at C2 carbon. We call it as APMers. So here both these compounds have same ozone reaction with phenyl hydrogen. If you take these two compounds, means when you react with ozone, means with phenyl hydrogen, what happens here? Same ozone with, means it will give same ozone reaction with C6H5NH2, phenyl hydrogen. So in the same way, in the first step, what happens, means here, in the first step, the CHO group, the CHO group of both compounds, of both compounds react with phenyl hydrogen. In the first step, CHO, if you have seen the ozone reaction, see here, when I'm treating with NH2, NH6H5, phenyl hydrogen, in the first compound, what happening? CHO is reacting with phenyl hydrogen. So in the same way, glucose and mannose react with C6H5, NH2OH. In the second step, what happens? There will be a change in C2 carbon of two compounds. To form C double bond O group. So, if you have observed the ozone reaction, when we are taking here OH, So when you are reacting with C double bond, where it is formed. So in the mannose also it will happen like that only. So in the second step there will be a change in C2 carbon. Yes or no? So whenever it is changing two compounds, what it is going to form? C double bond O group. So again in the third step what happens? The C double bond O group of both react with phenyl hydrazine molecule to form ozazone. Okay, so again what happening in the third compound when we are reacting with phenyl hydrazine, so it is forming ozazone. So like this it is going to form the ozazone reaction. Okay, so here D plus glucose and D plus mannose, D plus glucose and D plus mannose differ only in configuration at C2 configuration C2 at C3 C4 C5, they have same configurations. See here, only at C2 it is showing variation, but coming to C3 C4 C5 there is a same position. These type of compounds we call it as diastereomers. Okay, so this is about epimers. Now coming to anomers, anomers is nothing but what here? A pair of diastereomeric aldose that differ in configuration about C1 are called anomers. Means here also diastereomers we are taking, but coming to here what, only at first carbon it is going to differ. Here we are forming C2 and here C1 carbon, that one we call it as anomers here. So here example we are going to take alpha glucose and beta glucose. So now let us see HOH, OH, H, OH, C, H, CH2, OH, alpha form. What I have told you, if suppose it is in left side, we call it as alpha form. So in coming to beta form, OH is in right side, that one we call it as beta form. If you have observed the cyclic structure of glucose, I have explained the mutual rotation. So in the ring type of structure, so you will be having HOH here. So when you come here, O is turning this one beta form, this one alpha form. So at first carbon only there is change taking place, means OH is in left side, means that one alpha form. If OH is in right side, means that is a beta form. So here at first carbon there is a change taking place, that's why we call it as anomers. A pair of diastereomer aldoses, they differ only in configuration of C1 carbons, we call it as what? Anomers. So this is about epimers and this is about anomers. Okay, so I'll give you notes, write that. Thank you.